Hello, today I want to give you the best tips so that you can fast track your salsa journey and make sure that you're learning as fast and as efficiently as possible. If you want to grow at the fastest rate possible, make sure to listen up for these four tips. All right, so tip number one is not to measure your salsa journey in terms of years, but rather in terms of the amount of hours that you train per week. I think it's very common that a lot of people say, oh, I've been dancing salsa for about 1 year, I've been dancing for 3 years, I've been dancing for 10 years. But let's use a hypothetical situation where person A trains 1 hour per week and person B trains 4 hours per week. After the course of 5 years, person A will only have trained 260 hours while person B will have trained over 1,000 hours. So it's the same amount of years, but definitely the amount of hours of training is completely different. So avoid this trap of thinking that just as years go by, and if 2 years go by, 3 years go by, and you're taking 1 hour a week or even maybe 1 hour a month and then quitting and coming back, it is gonna be the same as somebody that has more hours of training and especially is more consistent. I would recommend, if you're already heading to the studio, make sure you take at least 2 classes since you're already there, and try to do that at least twice a week, and I promise you will grow at a much faster rate. Now, my second tip is to look out for the quality of your instructors. There's definitely instructors that have a lot more training and a lot more experience than others. So you want to make sure that you're training with a person that can prove or has a lot of experience or can show you that they have been successful in the industry, either because they have been successful themselves or because they have been able to produce a lot of successful students after them. Make sure to dig up and investigate the schools you're about to join, who the instructors are, how long have they been dancing, who was their teachers, because I'm certain that if you do this, certainly some teachers will pop up as much better options, and probably the amount that they charge is probably gonna be around the same. So you definitely want to make sure that you're receiving the best quality so that the amount of hours you put into training are actually with the best available teachers, either in your area or in your online school of choice. Now, my third tip is to go social dancing as much as possible. If you're taking classes, you want to make sure that you're putting into practice everything that you learn. And imagine if usually you take 1 or 2 lessons a week, when you pay for social, you're able to go for 4 to sometimes even 6 or 8 hours of practicing the moves you learn in class. So you want to make sure that you're using what you learn and not that you just learn it and not use it, because then it will be a lot easier to forget the material that you learn in class. Social dancing is also another amazing way of meeting great dancers. So I'm sure that if you make a lot of friends who are probably more advanced in the journey than you, they can help you out, give you some tips, and also maybe even practice with you sometimes on the side. So it definitely doesn't hurt to make those good contacts while social dancing. And what better way to practice what you learn in class than to have fun with your friends out in a night out of salsa dancing. So I think that's pretty cool. Now for my fourth tip is general, just to be consistent. I think this is where most dancers fall off the journey. They would come to class 1 month, maybe the next not. Maybe if somebody that is a performer had a bad competition or had a bad show, they would quit. But there's always gonna be ups and downs, and there are gonna be some very good days the same way that there are gonna be some not so good days. So what you want to do is just make sure that you're consistent, and in average, I promise you that you will grow at a very good rate the more consistent you are. Don't think about if you had a good day, if you had a bad day. Of course, we're human, so nobody's perfect. But being consistent, whether you're going to class and going to socials, or if you're competing or performing, make sure that you find a consistent schedule to keep doing that. So no matter the ups and downs, I promise you will keep growing. As a bonus tip, also, if you're somebody that started dancing on one and now you're transitioning to on two, here is the number one mistake I find on one dancers making when they try to dance on two. So make sure to click the link up here so you can check the tips I have for you. Anyways, thank you. If you found this content useful, make sure to smash the like button to support the channel. Subscribe so that I know that you enjoyed this video and you want to see more material. And make sure to comment down below any other topics that you would like me to cover. See you. Bye-bye.